what we have to understand is when we begin to deal with the word transformation, transformation signifies that there is a change in a condition or a change in the nature or a change in character. And oftentimes when you get women of God that come together and the presence of God begins to move between you all, there's nothing that can thwart or come against God being able to begin to transform and change some things in your life. Oh, come on, many of you have been going through some things in your life and even in your personal life, and I even hear God saying, even concerning this church, there's been some things that this church has endured as a body of baptized believers, and it's because you've been going through the transformation process. And oftentimes when you're going through the transformation process, it's not always an easy process. Understand that when God is beginning to transform you, it's a meshing and a meshing, and it's oftentimes going deep down in the reservoirs of your spirit and excavating some things that you did not know yet were laying dormant there, and he bring them up to your attention. Oftentimes there are former prophetic words that we have cast down and laid to the side that oftentimes that God will bring up and bring back to your remembrance. And oftentimes, even when he's bringing those words back, sometimes they're not always good, because it brings us face to face with the fact that we have not stayed on track with some things. Oh, but this ain't gonna be one of them messages. Hang on in there with me just a minute. And so understand that the transformation process is when it's changing your nature and changing your character. It's not always an easy process. It's not always one of those things that you endure with a smile. Sometimes when you're going through transformation and when you're going through change and when your nature is being processed, it's because the next place where God is trying to shift you to, there is an atmosphere that you must be prepared to be able to sustain yourself within. And in order to sustain a certain atmosphere, there has to be a change in your nature. And so understand that right now, what you're going through right now is not meant to harm you. It's not meant to cause you to be a castaway, but it's just simply meant to change your nature to prepare you for the next place that God already has prepared for you. Understand, I feel God preaching in this place, that God has ordained some things for your life. Many of you have forgotten about the purpose and the plan that God has had for you. Many of you have abandoned some aspects, not all, of your assignment. And so what God is doing right now is he's shaking some things, and he's causing some things that you set your hands to fall by the wayside, and he's causing you to endure some opposition right now simply because of the fact that God wants you to understand that he's recalibrating your focus because you're going somewhere. Look at somebody and say, I'm on my way, I'm on my way, I'm on my way somewhere. And so oftentimes transformation, especially when it's indicative and leading to growth, oftentimes it's not an easy process. And oftentimes it's actually a very hard place. Oftentimes it's a change in your original direction. Oftentimes you don't end up going the direction that you thought you were on your way to when you're being transformed. Because see, when you're being transformed, oftentimes transformation begins in your spirit and then it begins in your mind. Well, God begins to change your mind about some things. It begins to change your thoughts about some things, and he causes your thoughts to be calibrated with the sound and the thoughts of heaven. And that's what's going on in your life. And so oftentimes, in fact, transformation in this season is so important, because we're in a season where I believe that the enemy has sent out an express diabolic plot to send a spirit of opposition in the land. And oftentimes when we face oppositions, many times we think that opposition is of the devil. But I came to let you know in this place, all of the opposition that you've been going through is not of the devil. The opposition that Dale City's been going through is because God just wants you to know you right on time and you right on track for where God is taking you to. And oftentimes when we have opposition, we begin to look at opposition and we begin to look at it as if, oh my goodness, and it causes us to question, did God really say that? Did God really call us to this? It shouldn't be this hard if God really said it. We shouldn't have to go through this. Why us? Why me? Oh, come on. Can I bring it from the corporate level down to your house? Oh, come on. Many of us have been sitting here, right here under the sound of my voice, and you've been wondering why in the world that every single thing you touch seems to have been falling apart. Many of you feel like over the last couple months that you have just been fighting just to survive. Oh, come on. Am I talking to anybody in this place? It seems like when you take two foot to combat that what God has already said to you. And so what you got to understand is when you're standing in the face of opposition, that's the most imperative time that you must remember what God has said. Oh, when you're standing in opposition, you must remember Isaiah 54 and 17, which says, no weapon formed against me shall prosper.